This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Native American Party, renamed the American Party in 1855 and commonly known as the Know Nothing Movement, was an American political party that operated nationally in the mid-1850s. The movement arose in response to an influx of migrants and promised to purify American politics by limiting or ending the influence of Irish Catholics and other immigrants, thus reflecting nativist and anti-Catholic sentiment. It was empowered by popular fears that the country was being overwhelmed by German and Irish Catholic immigrants, whom they saw as hostile to Republican values and as being controlled by the Pope, mainly active from 1854 to 1856. The movement strove to curb immigration and naturalization but met with little success. Membership was limited to Protestant men. There were few prominent leaders, and the largely middle-class membership was divided over the issue of slavery. Its most prominent leaders were U.S. Representative Nathaniel P. Banks and former U.S. Representative Louis C. Levin. The American Party nominated former President Millard Fillmore in the 1856 presidential election. Contents 1 History 11 Name 12 Underlying Issues 13 Rise 14 Leadership and Legislation 15 Violence 16 South 17 Decline 18 Electoral History 2 Presidential Candidates 3 Legacy 31 Fictional Portrayals 32 Use of the Term 4 See Also 5 References 6 Bibliography 61 Primary Sources 7 External Links History Anti-Catholicism had been a factor in colonial America but played little role in American politics until the arrival of large numbers of Irish and German Catholics in the 1840s. It then re-emerged in nativist attacks on Catholic immigration. It appeared in New York politics as early as 1843. Under the banner of the American Republican Party, the movement quickly spread to nearby states. Using that name or Native American Party or variants of it, they succeeded in a number of local and congressional elections, notably in 1844 in Philadelphia, where the anti-Catholic orator Louis Charles Levin was elected U.S. Representative from Pennsylvania's 1st District in the early 1850s. Numerous secret orders grew up, of which the Order of United Americans and the Order of the Star-Spangled Banner came to be the most important. They merged in New York in the early 1850s as a secret order that quickly spread across the North, reaching non-Catholics, particularly those who were lower middle class or skilled workmen. Name The name Know Nothing originated in the semi-secret organization of the party. When a member was asked about its activities, he was supposed to reply, "I know nothing." Outsiders called them Know Nothings, and the name stuck in 1855. The Know Nothings first entered politics under the American Party label. Underlying issues: the immigration of large numbers of Irish and German Catholics to the United States in the period between 1830 and 1860 made religious differences between Catholics and Protestants a political issue. Violence occasionally erupted at the polls. Protestants alleged that Pope Pius IX had put down the failed liberal revolutions of 1848 and that he was an opponent of liberty, democracy, and republicanism. One Boston minister described Catholicism as the ally of tyranny, the opponent of material prosperity, the foe of thrift, the enemy of the railroad, the caucus, and the school. These fears encouraged conspiracy theories regarding papal intentions of subjugating the United States through a continuing influx of Catholics controlled by Irish bishops obedient to and personally selected by the Pope in 1849, an oath-bound secret society. The Order of the Star-Spangled Banner was created by Charles B. Allen in New York City. Fear of Catholic immigration led to a dissatisfaction with the Democratic Party, whose leadership in many cities included Catholics of Irish descent. Activists formed secret groups, coordinating their votes and throwing their weight behind candidates sympathetic to their cause. When asked about these secret organizations, members were to reply, "I know nothing," which led to their popularly being called Know Nothings. Immigration during the first 5 years of the 1850s reached a level 5 times greater than a decade earlier. Most of the new arrivals were poor Catholic peasants or laborers from Ireland and Germany who crowded into the tenements of large cities. Crime and welfare costs soared. Cincinnati's crime rate, for example, tripled between 1846 and 1853, and its murder rate increased sevenfold. Boston's expenditures for poor relief rose threefold during the same Period, James M. McPherson, Battle Cry of Freedom, p. 131. Rise in Spring 1854, the Know-Nothings carried Boston, Salem, and other New England cities. They swept the state of Massachusetts in the fall 1854 elections, their biggest victory. The Whig candidate for mayor of Philadelphia, editor Robert T. Conrad, was soon revealed as a Know-Nothing. He promised to crack down on crime, close saloons on Sundays, and to appoint only native-born Americans to office. He won by a landslide in Washington, D.C. Know-Nothing candidate John T. Towers defeated incumbent Mayor John Walker Maury, causing opposition of such proportion that the Democrats, Whigs, and Freesoilers in the Capitol united as the anti-Know-Nothing Party. In New York, in a four-way race, the Know-Nothing candidate ran third with 26%. After the 1854 elections, they claimed to have exerted decisive influence in Maine, Indiana, Pennsylvania, and California, but historians are unsure due to the secrecy, as all parties were in turmoil and the anti-slavery and prohibition issues overlapped with nativism in complex and confusing ways. They helped elect Stephen Palfrey Webb as mayor of San Francisco, and J. Neely Johnson as governor of California. Nathaniel P. Banks, former Speaker of the Massachusetts House of Representatives, was elected to Congress as a Know-Nothing candidate, though he later aligned with Republicans and as such was elected Speaker of the United States House of Representatives. The results of the 1854 elections were so favorable to the Know-Nothings, up to then an informal movement with no centralized organization, that they formed officially as a political party called the American Party, which attracted many members of the now nearly defunct Whig Party as well as a significant number of Democrats and Prohibitionists. Membership in the American Party increased dramatically, from 50,000 to an estimated 1 million plus in a matter of months during that year. The historian Tyler Anbinder concluded, the key to Know-Nothing success in 1854 was the collapse of the second party system, brought about primarily by the demise of the Whig Party. The Whig Party, weakened for years by internal dissent and chronic factionalism, was nearly destroyed by the Kansas-Nebraska Act. Growing anti-party sentiment, fueled by anti-slavery as well as temperance and nativism, also contributed to the disintegration of the party system. The collapsing second party system gave the Know-Nothings a much larger pool of potential converts than was available to previous nativist organizations, allowing the order to succeed where older nativist groups had failed in San Francisco, California. A Know-Nothing chapter was founded in 1854 to oppose Chinese immigration. Members included a judge of the state Supreme Court, who ruled that no Chinese person could testify as a witness against a white man in court. Fillmore Donelson campaign poster. In the spring of 1855, Levi Boone was elected mayor of Chicago for the Know-Nothings. He barred all immigrants from city jobs. Abraham Lincoln was strongly opposed to the principles of the Know-Nothing movement but did not denounce it publicly, because he needed the votes of its membership to form a successful anti-slavery coalition in Illinois. Ohio was the only state where the party gained strength in 1855. Their Ohio success seems to have come from winning over immigrants, especially German-American Lutherans and Scots-Irish Presbyterians, both hostile to Roman Catholicism in Alabama. Know-Nothings were a mix of former Whigs, malcontented Democrats, and other political outsiders who favored state aid to build more railroads. Virginia attracted national attention in its tempestuous 1855. Gubernatorial Democrat Henry Alexander Wise won by convincing state voters that Know-Nothings were in bed with Northern abolitionists. With the victory by Wise, the movement began to collapse in the South. Know-Nothings scored victories in northern state elections in 1854, winning control of the legislature in Massachusetts and polling 40% of the vote in Pennsylvania. Although most of the new immigrants lived in the North, resentment and anger against them was national, and the American Party initially polled well in the South, attracting the votes of many former Southern Whigs. The party name gained wide but brief popularity. Nativism became a new American rage. Know-Nothing candy, Know-Nothing tea, and Know-Nothing toothpicks appeared. Stagecoaches were dubbed the Know-Nothing. In Trescott, Maine, a shipowner dubbed his new 700-ton freighter Know-Nothing. The party was occasionally referred to contemporaneously in a slightly pejorative shortening, NISM. Leadership and legislation. Historian John Mulkern has examined the party's success in sweeping to almost complete control of the Massachusetts legislature after its 1854 landslide victory. He finds the new party was populist and highly democratic, hostile to wealth, elites, and to expertise, and deeply suspicious of outsiders, especially Catholics. The new new party's voters were concentrated in the rapidly growing industrial towns, where Yankee workers faced direct competition with new Irish immigrants, whereas the Whig Party was strongest in high-income districts. The Know-Nothing electorate was strongest in the poor districts. They expelled the traditional upper-class closed political leadership class, especially the lawyers and merchants. In their stead, they elected working-class men, farmers, and a large number of teachers and ministers. Replacing the moneyed elite were men who seldom owned $10,000 in property nationally. The new party leadership showed incomes, occupation, and social status that were about average. Few were wealthy, according to detailed historical studies of once secret membership rosters. Fewer than 10% were unskilled workers who might come in direct competition with Irish laborers. They enlisted few farmers, but on the other hand, they included many merchants and factory owners. The party's voters were by no means all native-born Americans, for it won more than a fourth of the German and British Protestants in numerous state elections. It especially appealed to Protestants such as the Lutherans, Dutch Reformed, and Presbyterians. The most aggressive and innovative legislation came out of Massachusetts, where the new party controlled all but three of the 400 seats. Only 35 had any previous legislative experience. The Massachusetts legislature in 1855 passed a series of reforms that burst the dam against change erected by party politics, and released a flood of reforms. Historian Stephen Taylor says that in addition to nativist legislation, the party also distinguished itself by its opposition to slavery, support for an expansion of the rights of women, regulation of industry, and support of measures designed to improve the status of working people. It passed legislation to regulate railroads, insurance companies, and public utilities. It funded free textbooks for the public schools, and raised the appropriations for local libraries and for the School for the Blind. Purification of Massachusetts against divisive social evils was a high priority. The legislature set up the state's first reform school for juvenile delinquents, while trying to block the importation of supposedly subversive government documents and academic books from Europe. It upgraded the legal status of wives, giving them more property rights and more rights in divorce courts. It passed harsh penalties on speakeasies, gambling houses, and bordellos. It passed prohibition legislation with penalties that were so stiff, such as 6 months in prison for serving one glass of beer, that juries refused to convict defendants. Many of the reforms were quite expensive. State spending rose 45%. On top of a 50% hike in annual taxes on cities and towns. Extravagance angered the taxpayers. Few Know-Nothings were re-elected. The highest priority included a tax on the civil rights of Irish Catholic immigrants. After this, state courts lost the power to process applications for citizenship, and public schools had to require compulsory daily reading of the Protestant Bible, which the nativists were sure would transform the Catholic children. The governor disbanded the Irish militias, and replaced Irish holding state jobs with Protestants. It failed to reach the two-thirds vote needed to pass a state constitutional amendment to restrict voting and office holding to men who had resided in Massachusetts for at least 21 years. The legislature then called on Congress to raise the requirement for naturalization from 5 years to 21 years, but Congress never acted. The most dramatic move by the Know-Nothing legislature was to appoint an investigating committee designed to prove widespread sexual immorality underway in Catholic convents. The press had a field day following the story, especially when it was discovered that the key reformer was using committee funds to pay for a prostitute. The legislature shut down its committee, ejected the reformer, and saw its investigation become a laughingstock. Violence, fearful that Catholics were flooding the polls with non-citizens, local activists threatened to stop them. Tensions came to a head on the 6th of August 1855, in Louisville, Kentucky, where in a hotly contested race for the office of governor, 22 were killed and many injured. The Louisville riot was only the most spectacular of violent riots between Know-Nothing activists and Catholics in 1855. In Baltimore, the mayoral elections of 1856, 1857, and 1858 were all marred by violence and well-founded accusations of ballot rigging. In Maine, Know-Nothings were associated with the tarring and feathering of a Catholic priest, Father Johannes Bapst, in the coastal town of Ellsworth in 1851, and the burning of a Catholic church in Bath in 1854. South in the South, the American Party was composed chiefly of ex-Whigs looking for a vehicle to fight the dominant Democratic Party and worried about both the pro-slavery extremism of the Democrats and the emergence of the anti-slavery Republican Party in the North. In the South as a whole, the American Party was strongest among former Unionist Whig states. Rightist Whigs shunned it, enabling the Democrats to win most of the South. Whigs supported the American Party. Because of their desire to defeat the Democrats, their unionist sentiment, their anti-immigrant attitudes, and the know-nothing neutrality on the slavery issue in 1855, the American Party challenged the Democrats' dominance in Alabama. The know-nothings were a mix of former Whig, malcontented Democrats, and other political misfits. They favored state aid to build more railroads in the Fierce campaign. The Democrats argued that know-nothings could not protect slavery from Northern abolitionists. The Know-Nothing American Party disintegrated soon after losing in 1855 in Louisiana and Maryland. The Know-Nothings enlisted native-born Catholics in Maryland. The party's influence lasted at least through the Civil War. The American Party's governor, and later Senator, Thomas Holliday Hicks, Representative Henry Winter Davis, and Senator Anthony Kennedy, with his brother, former Representative John Pendleton Kennedy, all supported the United States in a state which bordered the Confederate States. Historian Michael F. Holt argues that Know-Nothingism originally grew in the South for the same reasons it spread in the North: nativism, anti-Catholicism, and animosity toward unresponsive politicos, not because of conservative unionism. Holt cites William B. Campbell, former governor of Tennessee, who wrote in January 1855, "I have been astonished at the widespread feeling in favor of their principles, to wit, Native Americanism and anti-Catholicism. It takes everywhere decline." Results by county indicating the percentage for Fillmore in each county. The party declined rapidly in the North after 1855. In the presidential election of 1856, it was bitterly divided over slavery. The main faction supported the ticket of presidential nominee Millard Fillmore, and vice presidential nominee Andrew Jackson. Donelson Fillmore, a former president, had been a Whig, and Donelson was the nephew of Democratic President Andrew Jackson, so the ticket was designed to appeal to loyalists from both major parties, winning 23% of the popular vote and carrying one state, Maryland. With 8 electoral votes, Fillmore did not win enough votes to block Democrat James Buchanan from the White House during this time. Nathaniel Banks decided he wasn't as strongly for the anti-immigrant platform as the party wanted him to be, so he left the Know-Nothing Party for the more anti-slavery Republican Party. He contributed to the decline of the Know-Nothing Party by taking 2/3 of its members with him. Many were appalled by the Know-Nothings. Abraham Lincoln expressed his own disgust with the political party in a private letter to Joshua Speed written in August 24, 1855. Lincoln never publicly attacked the Know-Nothings, whose votes he needed. "I am not a Know-Nothing, that is certain. How could I be? How can anyone who abhors the oppression of Negroes be in favor of degrading classes of white people? Our progress in degeneracy appears to me to be pretty rapid as a nation. We began by declaring that all men are created equal. We now practically read it. All men are created equal, except Negroes. When the Know-Nothings get control, it will read, all men are created equals, except Negroes and foreigners and Catholics. When it comes to that, I should prefer emigrating to some country where they make no pretense of loving liberty, to Russia, for instance, where despotism can be taken pure, and without the base alloy of hypocrisy." Historian Alan Nevins, writing about the turmoil preceding the American Civil War, states that Millard Fillmore was never a Know-Nothing nor a nativist. Fillmore was out of the country when the presidential nomination came and had not been consulted about running. Nevins further states that was not a member of the party. He had never attended an American gathering. By no spoken or written word had he indicated a subscription to American tenets after the Supreme Court's controversial Dred Scott v. Sanford ruling in 1857. Most of the anti-slavery members of the American Party joined the Republican Party. The pro-slavery wing of the American Party remained strong on the local and state levels in a few southern states, but by the 1860 election, they were no longer a serious national political movement. Most of their remaining members supported the Constitutional Union Party in 1860. Electoral history. United States House of Representatives election year. Hash of overall seats won. Presidency 1,844 and 6 227. 6 John Tyler 1,846 and a 230th. 5 James K. Polk 1,848 and a 233rd. 1,850 and 0 233rds. 1 Millard Fillmore 1,852 and 0 234ths. 1,854 and 52 234ths. 52 Franklin Pierce 1,856 and 14 237ths. 38 James Buchanan 1,858 and 6 238ths. 8 1,860 and 0 239ths. 6 United States Senate election year hash of overall seats won, presidency 1,844 and 058, John Tyler 1,846 and 060, James K. Polk 1,848 and 062, 1,850 and 062, Millard Fillmore 1,852 and 062, 1,854 and 62, 1 Franklin Pierce 1,856 and 566, 4 James Buchanan 1,858 and 266, 3 1,860 and 068, 2 Presidential candidates election year. Result nominees. President Vice President 1852 lost Daniel Webster, then, on Webster's death, Jacob Broom George C. Washington then Raynell Coates 1856 lost Millard Fillmore Andrew J. Donelson Legacy fictional portrayals. The American Party was represented in the 2002 film Gangs of New York, led by William Bill. The Butcher cutting Daniel Day-Lewis, the fictionalized version of real-life Know-Nothing leader William Poole. The Know-Nothings also play a prominent role in the historical fiction novel Shaman by novelist Noah Gordon. Use of the term the nativist spirit of the Know-Nothing movement was revived in later political movements, such as the American Protective Association of the 1890s and the Ku Klux Klan of the 1920s. In the late 19th century, Democrats would call the Republicans Know-Nothings in order to secure the votes of Germans, as in the Bennett Law campaign in Wisconsin in 1890. A similar culture war took place in Illinois in 1892, where Democrat John Peter Altgeld denounced the Republicans, the spirit which enacted the Alien and Sedition Laws, the spirit which actuated the Know-Nothing Party, the spirit which is forever carping about the foreign-born citizen and trying to abridge his privileges, is too deeply seated in the party. The aristocratic and Know-Nothing principle has been circulating in its system so long that it will require more than one somersault to shake the poison out of its bones. The term has become a provocative slur, suggesting that the opponent is both nativist and ignorant. George Wallace's 1968 presidential campaign was said by Time to be under the neo-Know-Nothing banner. Fareed Zakaria wrote that politicians who encourage Americans to fear foreigners were becoming modern incarnations of the Know-Nothings. In 2006, an editorial in the Weekly Standard by neoconservative William Kristol accused populist Republicans of turning the GOP into an anti-immigration, Know-Nothing party. The lead editorial of the May 20, 2007, edition of the New York Times on a proposed immigration bill, referred to this generation's Know-Nothings, an editorial written by Timothy Egan in the New York Times on August 27, 2010, entitled Building a Nation of Know-Nothings, discussed the birther movement, which falsely claimed that Barack Obama was not a natural-born United States citizen, which is a requirement for the office of President of the United States in the 2016 United States presidential election. A number of commentators and politicians compared candidate Donald Trump to the Know-Nothings due to his anti-immigration policies. See also 71st Infantry Regiment New York Bowery Boys John J. Crittenden James Green Hardy Samuel Hinks Know-Nothing Riot of 1856. Philadelphia nativist riots. Thomas Swan Third Party System references. Carrot brief bio of Banks here. Carrot Kemp, Bill, the 17th of January 2016. Know-Nothings opposed immigration in Lincoln's day. The Pantograph retrieved the 11th of April 2016. Carrot Ray A. Billington pp. 337, 380-406. Carrot Ray A. Billington The Protestant Crusade, 1800-1860. 1938 p. 242. Carrot John T. McGreevy Catholicism and American Freedom, A History. 2003 pp. 22-5, 34. Quotation. Carrot Anbinder, Nativism and Slavery, pp. 75-102. Carrot Tyler Anbinder Nativism and Slavery, p. 95. Carrot Michael C. LeMay 2012 Transforming America, Perspectives on U.S. Immigration. ABC Clio P. Carrot William E. Genap, Salmon P. Chase, Nativism, and the Formation of the Republican Party in Ohio, pp. 22-24. Ohio History, p. 93. Carrot John R. Mulker 1990 The Know-Nothing Party in Massachusetts, The Rise and Fall of a People's Movement. University Press of New England pp. 22-34 Carat Mary J. Oates, Lowell, An Account of Convent Life in Lowell, Massachusetts, 1852-1890 New England Quarterly 1988 pp. 101-18 In JSTOR reveals the actual behavior of the Catholic nuns. Carat Robert Howard Lord, et al., History of the Archdiocese of Boston in the Various Stages of Development, 1604-1943-1944 pp. 686-99 For more details, Carat Charles E. Deusner, The Know Nothing Riots in Louisville, Register of the Kentucky Historical Society 61-1963, pp. 122-47 Carat Maine Historical Society, Maine, A History, 1919 Volume 1 pp. 304-5 Online Carat Anthony Jean Carey, Too Southern to Be Americans, Proslavery Politics and the Failure of the Know Nothing Party in Georgia, 1854-1856, Civil War History 1995-41-22-40 Carat James H. Broussard, Some Determinants of Know-Nothing Electoral Strength in the South, 1856, Louisiana History, January 1966, 7, No. 1, pp. 5-20 Carat Jeff Frederick, Unintended Consequences, The Rise and Fall of the Know-Nothing Party in Alabama, Alabama Review, January 2002, 55, No. 1, pp. 3-33 Carat Tyler Anbinder 1992 Nativism and Slavery, The Northern Know Nothings and the Politics of the 1850s Oxford University Press p. Political Conflict, 1888-96-1971 pp. 108-147-160 Carat Louise Phelps Kellogg, The Bennett Law in Wisconsin, Wisconsin Magazine of History, Volume 2, / 1 September 1918, p. 13 Carat Jensen The Winning of the Midwest, p. 220 Carat Craig Shirley How the GOP Lost Its Way, The Washington Post, April 22, 2006, pa. 21 Carat The Immigration Deal, The New York Times, May 20, 2007 Carat Egan, Timothy Building a Nation of Know-Nothings, The New York Times, August 27, 2010 Carat https://nineteen/09/19/as-trump-turning-the-gop-into-the-no-nothing-party-and-205409-7/page/full-carat-http://neuropublic.com/article/122427/donald-trump-isn't-first-know-nothing-capture-american-hearts Carat Bibliography Anbinder, Tyler Nativism and Slavery, The Northern Know-Nothings and the Politics of the 1850s 1992 online version, also online at ACLS History e-book, The Standard Scholarly Study Anbinder, Tyler, Nativism and Prejudice Against Immigrants, in a Companion to American Immigration, ed. By Reed Ueda 2006 pp. The Election of 1856 Tennessee Historical Quarterly 2003-623-218-237-ISSN-0040-3261 Donelson was Andrew Jackson's nephew and KN nominee for Vice President – Mark New Light on the Dark Lantern, The Initiation Rites and Ceremonies of a Know-Nothing Lodge in Shippensburg, Pennsylvania Pennsylvania Magazine of History and Biography 2003-1271-89-100-ISSN SN-0031-4587 Genap, William E. Nativism and the Creation of a Republican Majority in the North Before the Civil War. Journal of American History, Volume 72, No. 3 December 1985, pp. Hurt, Peyton, The Rise and Fall of the Know-Nothings in California, California Historical Society Quarterly 9 March and June 1930 Levine, Bruce, Conservatism, Nativism, and Slavery, Thomas R. Whitney and the Origins of the Know-Nothing Party Journal of American History 2001-882-455-488 in JSTOR McGreevy, John T. Catholicism and American Freedom, A History W. W. Norton, 2003 Mislish, Stephen East, The Meaning of Nativism and the Crisis of the Union, The Know-Nothing Movement in the Antebellum North, in William Genap, ed. Essays on American Antebellum Politics, 1840-1860-1982 pp. Journal of Massachusetts 2028 No. 2 Online Voss Hubbard, Mark Beyond Party, Cultures of Antipartisanship in Northern Politics Before the Civil War 2002 Parme, Robert D. Connecticut's Know Nothings, A Profile, Connecticut Historical Society Bulletin 1966, 31 No. 3, pp. Samuel Clagett Busey Immigration, Its Evils and Consequences 1856 Online Edition Anna Ella Carroll The Great American Battle, or, The Contest Between Christianity and Political Romanism 1856 Online Edition Fillmore, Millard Fillmore Papers ed. By Frank H. Severance 1907 Online Edition The Wide Awake Gift, A Know-Nothing Token for 1855-1855 Online Edition External Links Wikimedia Commons has media related to Know-Nothing Nativism in the 1856 presidential election Nativism by Michael F. Holt, Ph.D. Lager Beer Riot, Chicago 1855 Know-Nothingism Catholic Encyclopedia. National political parties in the United States List of political parties in the United States Major parties Democratic Republican Third parties Larger 1 Green Libertarian Smaller 2 American 1969 American Freedom American Populist America's American Solidarity Black Riders Liberation Christian Liberty Citizens Communist Constitution Democratic Socialists Freedom Road Socialist Freedom Socialist Humane Independent American Justice Legal Marijuana Now Marijuana Modern Whig National Socialist Movement New African Black Panther New Black Panther Objectivist Pacifist Peace and Freedom Pirate Progressive Labor Prohibition Reform Revolutionary Communist Socialism and Liberation Socialist Socialist Action Socialist Alternative Socialist Equality Socialist Workers Unity Veterans Working Families Workers World World Socialist Former Parties America First American Know Nothing American 1924 American Nazi American Vegetarian Anti-Masonic Black Panther Boston Tea Citizens Commonwealth Land Constitution 1952 Constitutional Union Democratic Republican Farmer Labor Federalist Free Soil Gold Democrats Greenback Independence 2007 Labor 1919 Labor 1996 Liberal Republican Liberty National Republican National States Rights National Union 1864 Natural Law New Alliance New Union Nullifier Opposition Populist People's Personal Choice Progressive 1912 Progressive 1924 Progressive 1948 Raza You Need a Readjuster Silver Republican Socialist Socialist Labor States Rights Dixiecrat Unconditional Union Union 1936 Unionist 1850s, 60s U.S. Labor Whig Youth International 1 At least 100,000 registered party members nationwide 2 Fewer than 100,000 members state and local political parties without national body presidential nominating conventions Politics of the United States Politics Portal